Good afternoon, dear sisters and brothers in Christ. Viva la Virgen! Today is Sunday of the 25th week in Ordinary Time. We celebrate today the solemnity of the Most Blessed Virgin Mary in her title as Our Lady of Peña Francia. The Filipino tradition of honoring Our Lady of Peña Francia began in the Bicol region in 1710, when Miguel Robles de Covarrubias, the son of a Spanish government official, fell very ill. While ill, he and his family prayed to Our Lady of Peña Francia, and he vowed that if he recovered, he would construct a shrine in her name. When he recovered, he was eventually ordained a priest in Naga City and set forth his plans to construct the shrine. During the construction, he also ordered for an image to be made, similar to the one he prayed to while sick. Unfortunately, the local artisans had run out of red paint, and so a dog was killed in order to coat and paint the image. This prompted to a miracle as the dead dog was thrown into the river, began to swim to the bewilderment of hundreds of people. News of many more miracles also spread, and so did the devotion to Our Lady of Peña Francia. Today, millions of people gather every year on the third Sunday of September in the Bicol region to honor Our Lady of Peña Francia. Our Mass presider for today is Reverend Father Ronald Ray Espartinez, SVD, Vice Rector of the Shrine. Our celebration will now begin. Please rise.
In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Friends, to those here in the shrine and those in the online, I warmly welcome you all in this holy celebration. We are here at the Diocesan Shrine of Jesus the Divine Word, Christ the King Mission Seminary, Quezon City, Philippines. In this Holy Mass, we thank God the Father for sending Mary to us, for calling Mary to be the mother of Jesus and to be our mother too. Mary is a prudent servant of God. She responsibly took good care of Jesus and taking good care of us. We too are called to become prudent servant. We also bring into this holy altar our pains, our wounds, our requests for healing, for deliverance. And so for us to worthily offer ourselves in this holy celebration, let us first recall our sins and ask God for His pardon and mercy. Together we say, I confess to Almighty God
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Amos. Hear this, you who trample upon the needy and destroy the poor of the land. When will the new moon be over, you ask, that we may sell our grain, and the Sabbath that we may display the wheat? We will diminish the ephah, add to the shekel, and fix our scales for cheating. We will buy the lowly for silver, and the poor for a pair of sandals. Even the refuse of the wheat we will sell. The Lord has sworn by the pride of Jacob. Never will I forget a thing they have done. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise, you servants of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. Blessed be the name of the Lord, both now and forever. High above all nations is the Lord. Above the heavens is His glory. Who is like the Lord our God, who is enthroned on high and looks upon the heavens and the earth below. He raises up the lowly from the dust. From the dunghill He lifts up the poor, to seat them with princes, with the princes of His own people.
Reading from the first letter of Saint Paul to Timothy. Beloved, first of all, I ask that supplications, prayers, petitions, and thanksgivings be offered for everyone, for kings and for all in authority, that we may lead a quiet and tranquil life in all devotion and dignity. This is good and pleasing to God our Savior, who wills everyone to be saved and to come to knowledge of the truth. For there is one God. There is also one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus, who gave himself as ransom for all. This was the testimony at the proper time. For this I was appointed preacher and apostles. I am speaking the truth. I am not lying. Teacher of the Gentiles in faith and truth. It is my wish, then, that in every place the man should pray, lifting up holy hands without anger or argument. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please rise to honor the Holy Gospel.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, a rich man had a manager who was reported to him for dissipating his property. He summoned him and said, "What is this I hear about you? Give me an account of your service, for it is about to come to an end." The manager thought to himself, "What shall I do next? My employer is sure to dismiss me. I cannot dig ditches. I am ashamed to go begging. I have it. Here is a way to make sure that people will take me into their homes when I am let go." So he shall in each of his master's debtors, and said to the first, "How much do you owe my master?" The man replied, 100 jars of oil." The manager said, "Take your invoice. Sit down quickly and make it 50. Then he said to a second, "How much do you owe?" The answer came, 100 measures of wheat. And the manager said, "Take your invoice and make it 80. The owner then gave his devious employee credit for being enterprising. Why? Because the worldly take more initiative than the other worldly when it comes to dealing with their own kind. What I say to you is this: make friends for yourselves through use of this world's goods, so that when they fail you, a lasting reception will be yours. If you can trust a man in little things, you can also trust him in greater, while anyone unjust in a slight matter is also unjust in greater. If you cannot be trusted with elusive wealth, who will trust you with lasting? And if you have not been trustworthy with someone else's money, who will give you what is your own? No servant can serve two masters. Either he will hate the one and love the other, or be attentive to the one and despise the other. You cannot give yourself to God and money. Friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Hello, everyone. We are happy to see you here in the shrine. Allow me to start my homily sa isang kwento. You know, ng kinder 1, kinder 2, pinasok ko ng nanay ko sa malaking school. Sa isang classroom ay 50 kami. Basta mag-kinder 2 na ako, hindi ako natuto magbasa. Kaya by grade 1, nilipat ako kami sa maliit lang na school. Per grade level, isang classroom. Kaya, ng grade 3 ko, nakapunta ako sa isang school na napakalaki, namangha ako. Kasi malaki yung school, ang daming classroom. At nakita ko ang classroom nila, bawat entrance may pangalan. May nakalagay, honesty, truthfulness, ang iba naman, resourcefulness. I was told, bakit pala may pangalan ang mga classroom, may purpose pala iyon, para maukit daw sa isip ng mga bata at kamalayan ng mga bata yung kahalagahan ng mga kaugalian na iyon. Para sila yung maging honest, maging truthful, at maging resourceful. Pero may manabasa ako doon ng mga pangalan na hindi ko magets, may nakalagay initiative, responsible, at yung isa prudent, prudent. Those words were big for me. Pero later on, naintindihan ko, pag sinabi palang initiative, may initiative ka, meron kang kusa na kahit di ka pagsabihan, ikaw na yung gagalaw. Yung salita naman na responsible, meaning gagawin mong matino yung trabaho at maayos. Ano naman yung prudent? Ang prudent pala, ang Latin word niya ay prudentia, meaning foresight. Iniisip mo yung magiging epekto at mangyayari sa buhay mo, hindi lang ngayon, kundi sa mangyayari sa kinabukasan. At alam nyo, being Christians, we are prudent because we always expect for the best. We always hope for the best because we believe the best is yet to come. We are prudent people. We have foresight. Minsan, naala ko, ano connection nito sa gospel, because yung gospel is asking us to be prudent. Sabi ni Jesus, kung yung mga nangluloko nga, mas matatalino, dapat yung mga anak din ng Diyos, matatalino din, dapat prudent. Naalala ko tuloy yung kwento ng elementary kami, yung grasshopper and mga ants, yung tipaklong one day naglalaro sa init, nag-i-enjoy siya, napadaan yung mga ants, may bit-bit na tatrabaho. Sabi ng tipaklong, bakit pa kayo napaka-busy? Laro na lang tayo dito maghapon. Sabi ng ants, naghahanda kami sa tag-ulan. Sabi ni ng tipaklong, malayo pa naman tag-ulan at hindi tayo mawala ng pagkain kasi tinayo ang daming pagkain sa tabi. Pero hindi pa rin yung mga ants nakipaglaro si tipaklong. So yung tipaklong, the coming days, naglaro lang siya, patulog-tulog, naghanda lang siya ng mga pagkain na malapit ng tag-ulan. Tag-ulan na. Nako, kaso lang yung ulan, ang haba. So naubos yung inipon na pagkain ng tipaklong. Wala na siyang makain. Lumapit siya sa mga ants, nagingi na pagkain. Una binigyan siya. Kaso lang, naubos agad, bumalik ulit siya sa mga ants. Pinagsabihan na siya ng mga ants. Wala na kami maibibigay sa iyo. Di ba ito yung sinabi ko sa iyo? Di ba we told you about this? Sabi ni tipaklong, I thought this is not going to happen. I was wrong. So mga kapatid, please be prudent. Please be like the ants. This is also the message sa inyo. Please don't copy the tipaklong. Always prepare something for your life. Please make decision only after a thorough considerations of the factors in your life. Kasi lahat kasing ating decision talaga sa buhay, merong consequences. At alam nyo, being prudent has many applicable sa ating buhay. Bigyan ko kayo, una, sa mga nag-aaral ngayon, please study hard. prepare for your future. Use your time well to build your self-confidence and communication skills. Yung lola ko nang bata kami, chine-check niya yung mga apo niya. Sino sa inyo nakapag-tiki-tiki? Hindi ako nagtataas kasi hindi kami pinapain ng tiki-tiki. Nang matanda na ako, tinanong ko lola ko, bakit lola kailangan ng tiki-tiki ang bata? Tinan mo yung mga anak ng tita mo, pinapain ng tiki-tiki. Ang gagaling sa math, sa English, may laban sa buhay. Sumang sa mga bata ngayon, you know why you have to prepare you for your future? Para may laban kayo sa buhay. Be prudent. Be prudent now. Pangalawa, sa mga gusto mag-asawa, please enter marriage if you are convinced it's really the call of God for you and if it's the mission of God for you and if you are willing to give your time and your whole heart to the commitment. Kasi marriage is living together. Diba, you have different attitude and makikipamuhay ka. So you must be prudent in making decision. Sa may mga trabaho, sa may mga negosyo, please protect your capital. Please protect your capital. Because if you're going to spend it without thinking properly, baka may bankruptcy. Sa may mga now hopeless, this is to tell you, there's no reason for you to give up. Because problem is temporary. Dapat may foresight ka. You must know that better future is ahead. To those afraid of dying, dapat may foresight, may life after death. At pati rin po ang prudence din, magagamit din natin sa family life. Especially on your decision sa mga anak mo, sa asawa mo. To give you a example, may nabasa akong kwento ng isang babae na adult na siya, pero hininakit siya sa mga magulang niya. Sabi niya, my parents walang prudence. Bakit? Kasi nang bata daw siya, I think nasa murang edad pa lang siya, miniting siya na kanyang tatay-nanay nang bata pa siya. Sinabi sa kanya, dear, me and your daddy nag-usap na nag-desisyon that we cannot anymore live together. We will file for divorce. We will take separate path. But don't worry. You will stay with me and your father will look after you. Ibig sabihin magtutulong. Pero sabi ng adult na siya ito, I was too young that time. I did not know what to answer to them. And she didn't even know what to feel. Later on, nasabi niya, di malamang ako kinonsult ng mga magulang ko na nagde-decide na pala para sa akin. Di man nila kinonsider na yung decision nila will affect my emotional life, even my personality. Bakit from the first start, they did not consult and have the foresight of what I'm going to feel. Ganun pala kung may bibitawan kayo mga desisyon, kahit please, look, what will be the consequence? That iniisip nyo na, ano kayong maramdaman niya? What will happen to him after 20 years after this? So, this tells you, before making big moves and choices, take in consideration the heart of the people that will be affected. Kasi po, may social effect talaga ang ating decision. Naala ko yung sa National Geographic. National Geographic. Nanonood kasi ako dati ng air crash investigation. Diba sa Amerika kasi, pag may nahulog na nag-crash na aeroplano, hukayin talaga nila yan eh. They want to know the root cause para din na maulit. Kasi may isang aeroplano bumangga sa mountain. Tapos, pinahukay nila lahat ng later sa findings, wala namang problema yung aeroplano. So, pag ngayon, dipunta naman sila sa mga piloto kasi daw human error. They found out, yung piloto pala, gabi nang bago siya nag-drive, nag-inom siya ng maraming beer. So, may hangover siya. So, mali yung calculation niya. Nakita niyo na yon, nakapatay pa siya ng 300 na tao. He was not prudent. So, friends, you see how crucial your decision and your choices. It can either make or break people. I hope you choose positive things para you can contribute good things to this world. Sabi ni Albert Camus, if you have nothing good to contribute in this world, please don't add bad things. Anyway, to close his homily, kahit po yung pagiging prudent, meron pong relasyon sa ating kinabukasan sa kabilang buhay. Ating pagiging prudent, every decision you are doing now will have effect on your future destiny in the afterlife. In short, so live your life in view of your eternal destiny. Sana every day is a preparation. Do not be consumed and to be attached in this world, even in your problem. Anytime we can go, you have only one life to live, so live it. It is irreplaceable. Please live a life that matters. And please consider always giving positive impact to the life of people. May kaibigan ako, to close this homily, you know, this itong kaibigan ko was well-to-do kasi they own a very big company across the Philippines. Pero pag tinan mo siya, para lang siyang yagit. Parang madumi siya tingnan, parang hindi siya nagdadamit ng maayos. At alam nyo, masaya sa kanya mga employer kasi magsasawa ka, kakausapin ka talaga niya. Magkwentuhan kayo ng 2 hours. Tapos he was really helpful all along. But he died suddenly. Ngayon, sa eulogy, sabi ng kanyang asawa, many times daw, nag-away sila ng kanyang asawa kasi di nagpapaalam, helping many poor people. But she was happy to know that his husband has done plenty of things. Tapos sabi ng kanyang sister din sa eulogy, you know my brother, although she died suddenly, but I believe she was preparing for the day of his death beforehand. She was preparing every day by the way he cares, he works, how he loves his family and the poor around him. Friends, please be prudent, servant of the Lord all the time. We rise to glorify the Lord by professing our faith. I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. He rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church, and I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayer of the faithful. Almighty Father, through your Son's incarnation, ministry, passion, death, and resurrection, you enable us to realize and respond to our true dignity as your adopted children. Help us to stay true to this gift and responsibility as we say, Father, help us share in the richness of your kingdom.
Father, help us share in the richness of your kingdom.
May Mary, Our Lady of Fenya Francia, intercede for the Christian people so that we may go forward in hope, relying on the help of Christ. We pray.
Father, through the richness of your kingdom,
may the Filipino nation never grow weary of invoking the Blessed Mother and always find refuge under her protection. We pray. May our Christian families and communities be centers of joy and mutual support and be protectors of life from conception to old age. We pray.
Father, help us through the richness of your kingdom.
May all of us find in Mary a model of prayer, service, and obedience to God's will. May we listen to her as she points to Jesus and says, "Do whatever he tells you." We pray.
Father, help us through the richness of your kingdom.
May the Lord welcome to the joy of paradise those who have gone ahead of us. We pray.
Father, help us through the richness of your kingdom.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Father, help us through the richness of your kingdom.
I also lift up to the Lord the special intentions of the following: Marisa Ramontero and Ophelia Hapson, and for the repose of the soul of Augusto Salire. All this we ask through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation. For you laid the foundations of the world, and have arranged for the changing of times and seasons. You form man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder. to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, I pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Onesto Ong Choco, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be called heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Gathering all our prayers into one, let us pray the Lord's Prayer. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Ang kapayapaan ng ating Panginoong Diyos ay laging sumainyo.
At sumaiyo rin.
Tayo po ay magbahaginan ng kapayapaan sa isa't isa. Peace to everyone, those in the online, across Facebook and YouTube channels, peace to all of you. Friends, this is our Lord Jesus Christ, the prudent Son of the Father, who took responsibility of all of his Father's children, and who brings light and salvation to each one. Behold him, for he is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment to receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
I soon.
magsitayo tayo. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption, both in mystery and in the manner of our life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please kneel for the prayer to Our Lady of Penyafrancia. Turn to me thine eyes, O most loving Virgin of Penyafrancia, and have mercy on my soul, that come to thee full of repentance. Protect my family, relatives and friends and benefactors. Intercede for your devotees, both the living and the dead, especially for those whom I am most obliged to help. Pray for me, console me, save me in my hours of peril, adversity, and afflictions, above all, in the hour of my death. Appear before your divine Son to help and defend me. Tell him that I am your devotee, that having complete trust in your protection, I kneel before your miraculous image to ask for your powerful intercession. Virgin of Penyafrancia, pray for me, help me, console me, and deliver me from all evil. Amen.
Please be seated for the announcement.
We invite everyone to join our Penyafrancia 2022 celebration. A solemn procession will follow after the Mass. The mantling or pagmamanto, a Bicolano tradition of blessing, will take place at the end of the procession at the Sanctuary of the Divine Word. Thank you. We all rise.
Remain seated. Yung ending ng procession ay sa Sanctuary Divine Word. Yan yung bagong construction na pinagawa ng Christ the King, headed by Father Jero Orbos, which soon to be open October 1. That will be the site for healing masses starting October 1. Sa mga sasama, at least makita nyo na rin. Pangalawa, to give an idea, anong purpose ng procession na yan, that's what you call journey. Kasi Mary was so faithful to Jesus, from the womb until the foot of the cross, Mary was with Jesus. Sana rin po tayo as we love one another from womb until suffering. Walang iwanan. Let us be faithful to one another and to our commitment. That's one way to be prudent. Pangatlo, yung ito palang shrine ay member ng dahil sa Cubao. May 48 parishes sa Cubao. Ngayon, yesterday, may namatay na pari ng Cubao, and the Bishop of Cubao, Bishop Honesto Onchoco of Cubao, asked to all the faithful, remember in your prayer, Father Emmanuel del Rosario. He is the parish priest of Transfiguration Parish sa Cubao, Project 4. He died yesterday of severe pneumonia. He was 47 years old. We keep him in our prayer. That's all. Magsitayo tayo for the final blessing. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Bestow increase of heavenly grace on your faithful, O Lord. May they praise you with their lips, with their souls, and with their lives. And since it is by your gift that we exist, may our whole lives be yours, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Friends, the Mass has been offered. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.